Hey there everyone, Hitesh here, back again with another video. And Windows 11 is officially out and very soon it will be available for every one of us. Now this video is all about my perspective as a programmer, that what do I think about Windows 11 and what are the things I'm super excited about. So let's go ahead and have a very small and teeny tiny discussion about Windows 11. A lot of people think that I just only work on Mac, which is not true. Yes, of course, in most of my videos and recording, I use Mac, but there is a reason behind that. Performance, optimization, and more control over things which I want there. But it's not like it is drastically different from Windows. This is my machine. This is Asus ROG Zephyrus machine, my alternative machine. Whenever I need to work on Windows, this is what I do. Now, since I have started to record this video, and even a little before that, this machine is getting updated, which is one of the problems that I have with the Windows. I cannot just start working on the Windows and can open it and start working. Sometimes it gives me issues like these updates, and sometimes it doesn't behave the performance that it was giving me on the day one. But I think Windows 11 is changing a lot about it. Now, of course, we know that now the Windows icon is at center, it has more glossy look and the rounded corners. That is overall aesthetic being changed, which is okay. I wouldn't call it as Windows 11 if these were the things that only got changed in Windows. I would probably call it as Windows 10.2 or something. But there is a lot that has changed in Windows 11, and especially a lot under the hood. Now we have more Linux support, it's much more Linux friendly. The binaries are being rewritten, as I'm being told my friends, that a lot of Microsoft binaries for the Windows have been rewritten to make it more friendly for programmers. We now even have package managers. So there's a lot that's going on, and I think this is all going on to retain the programmer community more into Windows. We all know that eventually the Windows programmers work on Windows, but eventually the goal is to move on to a Mac machine. And it's not a choice that we deliberately want to have. It's the performance reason why all companies distribute these Mac machines. Oh, by the way, a sidebar, because a lot of people ask these questions to me on Instagram. All the machines that you see on LinkedIn or Instagram posts that, hey, company gifted me a laptop, that's actually a company asset. When you leave the company, you have to give those assets back. So all those freshers who are not aware about this, no, they are not your machine. You just work on them. And when you leave the company, you have to give them back, whether it's an iMac or MacBook, whatever it is. Yes, I do agree there are programs to purchase those machines. Depends. Sometimes they let you keep it if it is too old, but that's for another day. See, when it comes to choosing an operating system, it is pretty clear choice based on what's your priority. If your priority is a little bit gaming outside the work hours, obviously you will be on Windows. If your priority is to learn more about the DevOps, then no matter what machine I give you, you'll be spinning up a lot of virtual machines, a lot of Linux on them. So it's really a polarized opinion and polarized choice when it comes to OS. One thing I'm super happy about now, that previously when I used to record videos for different softwares and different programming languages, it was a drastic difference between installation and environment setup between Windows and Mac and Linux. Now this gap is now closing out quite a lot. All the updates and all the installation process and environment setup process is now unified. So when you eventually move to Mac, or you stay on Windows, or you move from Mac to Windows, it's much more a unified experience, which is really important for programmers. So I think under the hood, Windows is doing a lot to retain the programming community into the Windows environment itself. Obviously, I don't expect the Windows to go to the extent length of changing the forward slashes to backslashes and all these things. No, that's never going to happen. That's the essence of how Windows was designed. I don't expect that. But more support towards the Linux command, a little bit of containerization support like Dockers and stuff, I still expect that. One of my favorite feature in the Windows 11 is snapping onto different screens. So when we attach a screen, it gives you the exact same look and whatever the arrangement was there. I think this is really useful for me as a video creator, because I hook all the time all these machines with this gigantic monitor in front of me. So I do this a lot, and I think more videos which I'm gonna be making in the future on Windows, I will be using this feature a lot. When it comes to the true performance test, as soon as the Windows 11 comes in, I would love to install an Android Studio on this machine. I think that is an ultimate test to test out whether the system is doing anything related to good performance or bad performance, because that is really an insane software to work and just spin off on any machine at all. Okay, now there is one more big challenge with the Windows 11 for programmers, which is now Windows 11 allows you to run Android apps in Windows 11. Now this is going to be a nightmare for all programmers. Now especially I'm talking about the apps which are designed in Flutter and React Native. Because hear me out how this actually whole thing works as according to the presentation of Microsoft. So Android apps are being installed not on the Windows 11, but first from the Windows, you need to grab an Amazon environment or kind of a sandbox. So into these Amazon apps, you can install the Android apps. So can you see how much bridging is going on? You're first going on with the Android as a native, let's just say, and then it needs to run as a bridge into Amazon, and then it needs to bridge with the Windows. So already there are too much gaps going on. And if the app is being built up on Flutter and React Native, the bridging is quite a lot. So how much performance is going to be degrading there? So eventually the apps that you're seeing that are running absolutely fine in your Android devices will be lagging into Windows machine, and people will be giving you the trash reviews for that. Now this is going to be bigger of a challenge. Now eventually some of these apps which are heavily dependent on the camera permissions or some specific features of the mobile itself, these are not going to perform really well, and eventually thus a nightmare of the reviews that are going to be flooding into the apps. Honestly speaking, am I happy with this? Not at all, not even tiny bit. I think Windows could have gone into a little bit more length and could have provided a native support that now from the store you can run directly the Android apps. If that was your goal, to run and support all the Android apps, why take Amazon as a bridge? I'm pretty sure you have enough of team as well as great mind in the company itself that they can actually accomplish this task. Now, taking and joining hand with Amazon, I really think that doesn't make sense, and it's going to backfire a lot from the programming community. Mark my word, this is going to happen. Now, yes, I do understand that having an Android app into the Windows system itself, right now it's not looking good, but eventually there will be apps and people will come up with the use case scenario where you'll be just amazed, and it opens up a wide opportunity for the developer itself. But this Amazon bridge in between, that is the nightmare, the worst nightmare I can ever have. I don't know much, but let's see how the performance of these React Native, Flutter, Ionic, and all these other third party which claims to create a native app, but we all know behind the scene they don't create a native app, there is a bridge there. And now there are a lot of bridges, so what happens to the app when it crosses this many bridges? Time will tell. And also, I'm not nitpicking here, but just onto a very side note, I really didn't enjoy too much in the presentation part. The moment that the presenter said, I'm super excited, and then the dull face, absolutely zero expression, I'm not nitpicking here. Also, I saw some of the stiff shoulders. There was something definitely wrong with this presentation. I don't know what it was, but definitely it was something off that I saw there. Again, not nitpicking, but I felt it a little bit that way. So these are my initial opinion about Windows 11. I'm super excited to check out under the hood updates, the performance update. As soon as it's rolled out to everybody, I'll check it out. I'll install it on my machine. We'll spin it off. We'll roll out some tutorials on this channel being all recorded on Windows, and let's see how it performs compared to Mac. Even if it is like 70 to 80% like Mac, but I would say that that's a good improvement. So let's see, and eventually the time will tell that now it is that good of a Windows that it can retain a programmer community just right in Windows, or still the goal would be eventually to move on Mac. Let me know what's your opinion about eventually moving to Mac. Is it still going to be a trend? Let me know in the comment section.